Hi, Steve Bornfield here from Chatsworth Products. We're inside of our research, development, and training center in our thermal lab, where we do a lot of testing of our own products, but also testing some of the customers' configurations. I'm here to help you clean up those myths and those mistakes that you might make within your data center space. Different elements that we can do to potentially improve your efficiency, but also your flexibility. During this video, we're going to talk about the cabinet ecosystem and how we can go through and help you optimize your space and maybe fix some of those issues that you might be having. So we're now in a small data center, and what we're going to talk to you about is the low-hanging fruit. Many customers come to us and ask us, what can I do to improve my solution or my cooling inside my data center? So part of Chatsworth's total cabinet ecosystem is our ability to go through and contain the hot air and separate that from the cold air. So what we're going to do is we're going to go through and point out some of the common mistakes within the cabinets and what you can do to improve your efficiency with a very small investment or a very low amount of effort. So as we go through this, we're going to go through and understand some of the challenges that we have out there and what we look for within the cabinet. One of the key items is how the devices are racked. One of the first challenges that we have is when our folks don't put their devices on the proper U spacing. They put it off half a U. That goes through and it makes it where you can't blank around that device, such as what we have here. So whenever you go through and you have that, you can't install a blank to properly seal that. Of course, any open slots that you have within your cabinet, those should be sealed. Those are key. So you're going to go through and you're looking for any open slots, as you see both here at the top as well as here in the middle. Then one of the other items that you're going to look for is the bottom panel. Of course, in this cabinet, it doesn't have one. So this is allowing that hot air to be pulled back around. So what we've done to, shall we say, accommodate for that is we've moved the devices all up. Typically in a cabinet, you rack from the bottom up. In this cabinet, it was from the top down. This is to where we can go through and minimize that air recirculation. In Chatsworth's total cabinet ecosystem, we'd have a bottom panel. So one of the other key items is the side gap here between your rails and the side panels. Those we go through and we seal up to prevent any of that air recirculation from the side. So looking at this, we've got leakage from the sides, the top, the middle, as well as the bottom. In this next cabinet, we'll be able to go through and see how we've been able to address that. Now I understand this is more of a network cabinet and this is a server cabinet, but regardless of the solution, we can go through and make those changes to where you can seal it up properly. So in this cabinet, as you look through it, you will see where all the open slots are sealed. We don't have any blanks that are open. Everything is completely sealed on the front. On our sides, from our side rail to the side of the cabinet, everything's blanked off. Any cable penetrations, you've got grommets in there to prevent any air leakage. This, once again, is all part of Chatsworth's cabinet ecosystem. It's to go through and seal those points to make sure that we don't have those leakages. So in this design here, the ability for that hot air to be re-ingested is eliminated.
To learn more, visit our website or give us a call. Thanks for watching.